Parashat Kedoshim, undoubtedly one of the most important verses of the Bible, V'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, you shall love your friend like yourself. There are two critical questions about this verse. First of all, how can I truly get to love my friend as much as I love myself? Self-love is not denied by the Bible. In fact, what this very verse says is that self-love is critically important. You shall love your friend like yourself. It is almost as though the Bible is teaching us that if you don't love yourself, you're not going to love anyone else either. And I've often believed that this verse tells us that often it is a mitzvah, a commandment, to go to a proper psychoanalyst, psychologist, psychiatrist, in order to try to come to love yourself. Because love is very much like a bank. If you don't put money in, you can't take money out. And if there's no love within yourself which gives you self-worth, it's very difficult for you to have the wherewithal to give love to others. The love that you're giving to others must come from the excessive love that you have for yourself. The difficult but real truth is that most of the self-love that we have, if it's healthy self-love, comes from our parents. And from our most formative years, when we felt worthy of being loved. So the first thing is for the individual to feel himself worthy of being loved and having an excess of love to give to others as well. And it's a magnificent notion because it's based upon the fact that each of us is created in God's image and each of us has a part of God within ourselves. And God is goodness and worthy of being loved. And an aspect of us is directly from God's own goodness. It's the portion of God from on high that breath of life which God breathed within us at the time of creation. And since we're all created from God's essence, children of God, we are worthy of being loved. So the first thing that the verse tells us is that we must love ourselves if we are to be able to love others. And what does it really mean to love others as much as we love ourselves? Well, in the tractate Shabbat 31a, when that would-be convert came to Hillel and said, I would like to be a convert, but on the condition that you teach me the entire Torah on one leg. Until I said to him, Madisana alach al tavid lachavrach, what is hateful to you, do not do to your friend. That is the Torah. All the rest is commentary. Go out and learn it. What is hateful to you, do not do to your friend. That is what loving yourself, loving your friend like yourself means. Don't do to him what you wouldn't want him to do to you. That's why, or one of the reasons why, the verse says, V'ahavta l'reacha, love towards your friend, act in a loving fashion towards your friend, without it being simply the objective case. Et, V'ahavta et re'echa. Love yourself, love your friend like you love yourself. What the Bible is really saying is, act towards him as you would want others to act towards you. That's really what the verse expects of you. It doesn't expect any individual to feel towards every other individual the kind of concern that he feels for himself. There's only one exception to that rule, and that's your spouse. The Talmud says very clearly that the major interpretation of V'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, you shall love your friend like yourself, goes on one's spouse. That's why under the nuptial canopy, the verse is Sameach desamach re'im ha'uvim. Be glad and rejoice, loving and beloved friends. The Talmud says it's forbidden to marry a woman unless you love her. As the Bible states, you shall love your friend like yourself. So therefore, I would say, from this perspective, a very critical commandment to love your friend like yourself. You must first of all love yourself. Try to get rid of most of those hang-ups that make that an impossibility. But the extra love that you have within, give to others. In general, you're expected to treat others as you want them to treat you. With your spouse, it must go beyond that. And you must truly try to feel the same kind of commitment to your spouse as you have to yourself. Shabbat Shalom.